If I do something like this, take a particular example, z3 I, where what's I? I is the imaginary unit. I squared is negative one. This does turn out to be a field, in spite of its notational similarity to that. Why are the notations similar, and what exactly is this thing here? You could think of this as the set of all polynomials with coefficients from Z3 in the indeterminant I. I could write that. I could write all polynomials with coefficients from Z3 in the indeterminate. I'm not going to call it a variable. I'll just use the word indeterminate. I, however, it's a little bit more. We also want to emphasize I really is the so-called imaginary unit. Its square is negative one. And so if you do ordinary polynomial addition and multiplication, maybe I'll put the word ordinary in quotes here, under ordinary polynomial addition and multiplication mod 3, where the coefficients are always simplified mod 3 to being either 0, 1, or 2 when you simplify, you could think of it as a ring of polynomials. However, the word ordinary is in quotes because those polynomials can always be simplified using the fact that I squared equals negative one to a linear polynomial. Back in the other example we did where we did this calculation, if all these x's were i's, where I squared is negative one, then this term, for example, 2x squared would be 2i squared, would be 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. Mod 3 is positive 1. This would be 2i cubed. If I squared is negative 1, then I cubed is negative I. I cubed can always be simplified to negative I. I to the fourth is I squared is squared. Negative one squared is positive one. I to the fourth can always be simplified to positive one. What about I to the fifth? I guess that's I times I to the fourth. I times one is I. I to the sixth is I squared is negative one. I to the seventh is I cubed is negative I. I to the eighth turns out to be one. Hey, that forms a cyclic group, actually, of order four. I squared is negative one. I cubed is negative I. I to the fourth is positive one. And it keeps cycling. It's a cyclic group of order four. Anyway, you could always use these facts if you were doing this kind of calculation here to simplify the higher powers of I to linear powers, zeroth powers, or first powers. And what this means is that this is not the typical way to think of this ring. Instead, you can think of it as elements of this form, where a and b are from Z3, a linear polynomial, so to speak, in I. all the higher powers can always be simplified. And what this ultimately ends up meaning is this particular polynomial ring, we don't usually think of it as polynomials, but I said the word, is actually finite. In fact, it's got 3 times 3, 9 elements. 0 plus 0i, which yes is 0. 1 plus 0i, which yes we call 1. 2 plus 0i, which we call 2. 0 plus 1i, which we just call I. 0 plus 2i, which we call 2i. Then what's next? 1 plus 1i, which we just write as 1 plus i. 1 plus 2i. 2 plus 1i, which we just write as 2 plus i. And finally, 2 plus 2i. Those are the 9 elements of this ring. It's a finite ring. It's got 9 elements. Is it ring isomorphic to Z9, which would also have 9 elements? Just another example here is Z9 with no X would just have 9 elements. Nine is not prime. Z9 is not an integral domain. 3 times 3, for example, is 0 mod 9. Not an integral domain. ID for integral domain. Is this thing also not an integral domain? No, it is an integral domain. It's not isomorphic to Z9. In fact, it's a field. All the non-zero elements have a multiplicative inverse. Really? What would the multiplicative inverse of 1 plus 2i be, for example? I don't know. Let's see if we can figure it out. What do I need to multiply 1 plus 2i by to get 1? Set that equal to 1 and see if you can solve for a and b. See if it works. Simplify. Got a foil over here. 1 times a. 1 times bi, 2i times a, and then 2bi squared. I squared is negative 1. That's the same as 2bi squared. Replace I squared with negative 1, but then mod by 3. Negative 2 mod 3 is positive 1. So I get a plus b in the end for the term that does not involve an I, and the term that does involve an I is 2a plus b. I'm setting that equal to 1, and I'm wondering, are there values of a and b that make that equal to 1? Again, getting from here to here, I took the negative 2 and modded by 3 to get positive 1. Negative 2b is the same as b. So that's why I got a plus b there. Can I choose a and b so this equals 1, no matter what? Do some experimentation. I got to solve a system of equations. A plus b equals 1. A plus b equals 1. And 2a plus b equals 0 because there's no I term over there. Maybe subtract these equations from each other. Solve it like you're doing linear algebra. I'll subtract the bottom from the top. I get negative a plus 0 equals 1. In other words, modding by 3, 2a equals 1. Does that have a solution in Z3? Yeah, a equals 2. In Z3, right? Because 2 times 2 is 4, mod 3 is 1. Now use a equals 2 and solve for b. Plug it in there, for example. 2 plus b equals 1. Does that have a solution for b mod 3? Yeah, b equals 1. So it looks like a equals 2 and b equals 1 certainly solves this equation. Does it also solve this one? Let's double check. 2 times 2 is 4, plus 1 is 5. I must have made a mistake. Yes, thank you. B equals 2. 2 times 2 is 4, plus 2 is 6, mod 3 is 0. Yes, thanks for catching that. So it looks like what we found is the multiplicative inverse of 1 plus 2i is 2 plus 2i. 1 plus 2i inverse is 2 plus 2i. Weird but true in this ring Z3i. Kind of wild. Takes some getting used to. As you do the reading, this example is in the reading, by the way. Where is it? It's right there, page 270. It's even got a multiplication table for the non-zero elements. And from the multiplication table, you could figure out multiplicative inverses of every element. We just figured out, again, the multiplicative inverse of 1 plus 2i. Where is 1 here? It's there. Its multiplicative inverse is 2 plus 2i. Pretty important example, actually, for the rest of the semester. Okay, this is a field action. By the way, this Z3i star here, the star refers to the non-zero elements. That's consistent with our previous notation for things like R star and C star was the non-zero elements. Okay, make sure you really study this example well.